you are in need of some good advice, you better listen up because we have rounded up the Brains Trust. Three wise men ready to answer all of your burning questions. Tristan, Beau and Hugh, hello.
Hello.
Thanks for having us.
Are you ready for the curly questions?
Yes.
First one's from Kylie. What to buy a husband that has everything, including a fabulous wife, obviously?
Yeah, Kylie.
Hugh?
Well, I always say, because this is said of me, that I have everything, because I do have everything. I just say, look, I just want hugs. Just give me hugs.
Aww. Love don't cost anything. That's not going to fly Christmas morning, though, is it?
That's a rookie error here. You know what I like? I like time away with my wife, away from kids. So and it's a win-win situation. Mm-hmm. You buy a nice little hotel in the city or up the coast, down the coast, time away where it's just you two, because you never really get you two time, especially now with kids' sport, working around the clock on this show because one of you is faking illness every week. I like time away. I like time away with your spouse so you can not worry about their kids watching Cardi B and all that.
Yeah. All right, hugs, time away, and?
Oh, I just like doing things together. Similar to that.
Yeah.
But, I think what that relationship needs is a bit more honesty because he doesn't have everything. Well, he doesn't need everything. He just, I think you need to, when you're struggling for stuff like this, you kind of have to think of new experiences that you can both do together. Mm. Because generally you'll try to think of the things that he wants or we'll think of the thing that she wants or whatever it is. But, just do something new together that you haven't done before.
Can't buy more time.
Can't buy more time.
You can do hugging together.
You can hug whatever you want to, yeah.
Hugs are good, though.
This one is from Nathan. Nathan asks this. My in-laws are coming to our house for Christmas this year. I can never get rid of them. They arrive around 11 a.m. and end up staying until near midnight.
Yeah.
How can I get them to leave when I want them to, not when they want to? Yuck.
Just tell them straight off.
Mm.
Do one.
And don't tell them at 11 o'clock at night. You've got to tell them the day before. Great, you're coming. Fantastic. Look, you know, we're pretty wary at this time of year. We might head off to bed around about 9 o'clock. You don't mind. There's the fridge. Knock yourselves out.
Yeah.
Don't start turning the lights off, though.
Yeah, yes. No, that's hard.
Chairs
that's
on
hard.
The table.
I've got in-laws coming over on Sunday. Pumped. So I've got to watch what I say. There's two options. You can do what my wife does and when we have people over, and you come out in a robe. You know what I mean? You've just showered. You come out in a robe. No, nothing inviting, but you just come out, you know, you're going to have a shower, you're going to wrap it up, it's time to go.
She thinks that might be open to misinterpretation.
With the in-laws, you never know. Or what I like to do is I book something for that afternoon. So you have the in-laws over and then, I just remembered. And I'll text Tristan, call me. Remember, we've got that catch-up we got to do. We've got to help you with the fence.
I know nothing.
You got to play, because you got to have a few options up your sleeves, because the in-laws, they're pretty quick and they hang around.
But generally, that's a common occurrence. Like, that does happen to a lot of people.
Yeah.
And again, I know it's easy to say, but just honesty is always the best policy. I'll tell people, I was like, this is a bit too much for us. You need to have a little bit more self-awareness of what's going on in our lives as much as yours.
Oh.
We love having you here. Hard. We do. But, you know, it's very difficult for us when you leave. So come over, have the best time on earth, and we'll catch up tomorrow
until
for
7.
Yeah. We'll catch up tomorrow for lunch or breakfast, and we'll debrief what happened.
Honesty's
and I hope
hard.
You have a great Christmas.
Honesty's hard, though.
It is hard, but people appreciate it, I think.
You know what they used to do in the Brisbane nightclubs back in the day? They used to put on Boys of Summer at 5 in the morning. That'd make everyone leave.
See, that
Lights on Boys of Summer. Chloe has this question for you fellas. I struggled to get my kids off their phones. Any tips for getting my daughters off their devices and out into the backyard?
Go up into the backyard with them. And play as much as possible. That's a very simple answer to something. Mm. It's very difficult to get the children off the devices.
Very hard.
But there has to be something that seems more appealing than being on the devices. Mm. And you can try a whole bunch of stuff.
We had problems. That's a good one. COVID's made everything hard. The best part of 18 months, they've been on devices 24/7, which, and so they should be, with connection with their friends. But we set a time limit now because they're allowed to be outside. My kids are quite adventurous and they like it outside, but they can get stuck for... Starts at half an hour, 2 hours, but we set a time limit.
Mm.
The weather's killing us, though, at the moment as well, isn't it?
Mm. Yeah.
What about you, Hugh?
Well, we're thinking of buying a safe and putting the devices in the safe.
Mm.
And then, because it's hard, this is a really big problem. And I've got, you know, 3 school-age kids and they want to be on their devices 100% of the time.
Mm.
So you set an amount of time they can be on the devices, but then it's really hard to police it. My son snuck in the middle of the night to get his computer and was downstairs on the computer till he fell asleep and had no sleep the next day. It is addictive.
It's very tough, and it's, I guess it's you're trying to figure out, well, because we're all kind of accustomed to say, right, get up, you're on that for too long. Mm. And they go, well, what's the problem? And I think there's a part of us that doesn't really know what the problem is. We just feel as though it's probably the wrong thing to be on it all the time. So we're trying to find that balance all the time. And it's hard to tell a kid, get off that device and then be on our device trying to do work or trying to do whatever it is. So it's a very there's no easy answer to this. It just has to be whatever, prioritising what you want to get done or have something. Don't be on that. Let's go do this. Let's do this together. Let's try and do this and try and do that. It won't be that easy, but, I mean, you can only try.
You don't have a safe already?
Not one big enough for all the devices, I can tell you.
Yeah. But,
the other thing is that kids socialise through devices.
Yeah. That's right.
And my son plays Minecraft with mates and they're talking, chattering all the time while they're playing this thing. So it is tough. You've got to allow some time.
Do you remember when you used to have, there used to be like credit on your phones? You had to buy credit and up your credit for it. I don't know if it's a bad idea to have something like that for kids.
But
you
I guess...
You kind of, if you're in a family where you're lucky to get pocket money or something like that, or you give an allowance and it's go, look, that's your allowance. As soon as that's used, well, then that's used.
And
it's on you.
And the activities that they're doing outside has to be encouraging. They have to be things that they like to do. Luckily, like I said, my son and I, we like to get out and there's a lot of things that he likes that I like. But, yeah, my daughter is much harder. We have to dangle the carrot and find what she likes. And it's like they get a bit of withdrawals. When you take the device, it's like they're withdrawing. But after that first 10, 20-minute period, it's great.
I'm having this problem with my son too. Kate asks this. My son has picked up a bit of a bad habit. He's constantly lying. Oh. How do you get the truth out of kids?
Well, lying is part of it's a developmental process. The kids will lie, and they'll lie openly thinking they're going to get away with it for a while. All human beings lie. We lie into adulthood. So that illusion that we live in a lie-free zone is not true, but it's what you lie about. You want, obviously, you know, integrity goes with adulthood. But kids will lie if they can get away with it. So, and the initial lies from kids are quite easy to bust. And so you just have to kind of project the notion that you know when they're lying, you know the truth, and then they'll amend their lies.
Do you put on the Hugh Riminton 10 Years First voice when your kids are in really big trouble?
And the glasses and the suit and all that?
I always, they know they're in trouble when I'm putting on a suit.
We're going to court, kids.
Sorry, kids, I'm going to put on a suit for this one.
Like I said, it's part of developing, isn't it? Like, we're still trying to find the balance in that. And I can be quite stern at home, but I'll always tell the kids, I said, look, you won't get in trouble for doing anything wrong, but you will get in trouble for lying about it. And we're trying to kind of wean it out that way. Sometimes, again, it works. Sometimes it doesn't. But but we tell lies every now and again as well.
Yeah, that's the problem when they catch dad lying.
But there has to be accountability for it. I think that's we tend to kind of go, well, if you don't do this, we're going to take all your toys away with no intention of taking all those toys away.
It's the empty threats that bring us undone. Yeah. Duncan says, I'm in a new relationship. We haven't said the L word yet, but I'm ready to say it. Should I just take a leap or should I wait for him to say it first?
Yes, 100%. Do it, Duncan. Do it. Show your cards, mate. We try and encourage men in particular to be emotional, be honest, and it's the best way forward. I think, throw the L word up, even if you don't mean it.
Yes!
Throw it in early. Do you know what I mean? Worked good for me.
As the old...
Oh, my God.
Was it the Dirty Three song? Sometimes you've got to fake that emotion.
That's right.
No, don't do it. Don't.
Use it, mate.
No, don't.
Be honest. If your lover or him... Yeah. Throw it out there.
No, it's a him. Throw it out there.
You can't be afraid of your emotions.
No.
What's the worst that can happen?
Exactly.
There is a trick. You know, I am going to fall in love with you.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yes, that's a good one.
That's such a journo thing to say, isn't it?
No, but if you're kind of getting there.
I think I'm falling in love with you. Try that one first.
I am going to fall in love with you.
I think I'm about to fall in love with you. Try that one.
I hope we've answered your question, Duncan, and everyone else.
You're welcome.
Thank you, boys.
You're welcome.
Dilemma solved.
There you go.